Hello and welcome to this video where we're going to look at the installation process. A couple things that I want to assume right at the beginning of this video is that we have installed Lansweeper. It's syncing to Lansweeper sites. That we have an installation that has got new users been invited to it, that it has discovered what assets are on your environment and different assets from Windows devices, Linux devices, networking devices, many of those things that will really help you with your environment, making things easier for you to manage. So let's assume that this is all in place and let's take a dive into Lansweeper, discover some things that are there that might be actually in your environment as well and what we can learn from this. All right, getting into Lansweeper here, I've now logged in, I'm at the dashboard, and let's just review quickly what I'm looking at. In my particular lab that I have got configured here, I've got 125 assets. I can click on this as well that will take me to those assets. I can see the software that has been discovered here. I actually have 190 different users that have been discovered in my environment. Multiple labs, different domains. And this is an interesting one that I think we should discuss here is our scanning issues. But before we dive into that, let's look at these different reports even more. We have a report overview. These are ones that maybe we thought were important. Let's just say there's been a change. We can click on and run this particular report right now, and it will discover any changes, any additions. You can see that last time I ran it, 31 more of the VMware tools was added. There's lots of details on this main page here, this general overview dashboard that helps you get a quick overview of your environment. We have the same thing if we were going to the assets. And on this page, you can see more details about my assets, the total assets versus the new assets that have been recently discovered, what kind of workstations and servers, again, our scan issues that we're going to address. Lots of details here. But without going into every single one of these, you can still see we have the inventory health, a security overview, some software. If you have OT or operational technology scanning that's happening in your environment, this information will be discovered there, lifecycle and vulnerabilities. And if you need to, you can create your own dashboard. Again, we aren't going to go into all of these details, but you can create your own dashboard through the graphical interface here and add different things into the environment, into your dashboard that would be appropriate for you and what you might want to receive and for information. As you have seen, we have scanning issues in our environment. And this is something that can be somewhat common, and there's lots of reasons around this. We're not going to be able to do a deep dive into all of the reasons why, but let's talk about some of the reasons why potentially you may have some scanning errors. Let's go into my lab and see what scanning errors I have. So from my dashboard here, I'm going to click on my scanning issues, and this is going to take me over to all my scan issues that I have within my environment. Another way you can get to this as well, let me just click on our inventory tab, and with all of my assets being seen, we have these different columns over here on the top. This one here with a little triangle exclamation point is telling me this is where I have scanning issues. So I'm going to scroll down here and just grab some right here. So I can click and check this issue. I can also go into this particular asset. So let me open up this asset. And I can see I've got one scanning issue. And this was scanned 3 days ago. It says that the scanning problem is a printer spooler is disabled. All right, that's great to know. This may not be a scanning issue for you, but maybe this is in your environment for this particular asset. You want to have the print spooler enabled. This is up to you how you want to work with this. So that's just one example of a scan issue in your environment. To make things a little easier or more quick to be able to see the different scanning errors that you have, there's another way you can see all scanning errors, and let me show you that. We saw this from the dashboard, and this is another way you can get to it. You click on your scanning, go to scanning issues, all scanning issues, and now you see all the different scanning issues that I've got in my environment. Again, my lab needs some help, doesn't it? All right, but we can also look at specific scan issue types. Maybe you want to look at something that only the SSH errors or no valid credential found. This is a great one. where you can click on this, and now you see all of these different assets that I have not scanned correctly with the appropriate credential. So in this situation, I can find out which asset needs to be scanned with which type of credential, and we go and can create those credentials. So this is like just a quick overview of looking at scanning errors and how to find those errors in your environment. Because every environment is unique, trying to cover every use case and situation can be pretty difficult, but I would recommend that you go out to community.landsweeper.com, where there's many articles there about solving and helping to discover what's causing your scan issues in your environment. Next, let's look at comparing some credentials and the credentialless type of scans. And in my environment here in my lab, I have some assets that were scanned through the CDR, or the credential-free device recognition technology, and I have some that were scanned with my credentials. Let's compare the difference between these. Okay, so here I am in the inventory page, and I have my list of my inventory. Sometimes you might find that just seeing a list of 50 assets is not quite enough. You can come down here into the bottom right, and I'm gonna change this to 250, give myself the full list of all of my assets. And I'm gonna find an asset here that has got a scanning issue that does not scan correctly, but I can still get information about that. And this is the amazing thing about Lansweeper. Even though we have had some scanning errors and there's problems discovering that asset, because of our credential-free device recognition technology and the API connections to our library of assets and asset types, we're able to discover a little bit of information about that. Let's look at what some of that looks like. Here's an asset here that has been found that does not have the appropriate credentials, but you can see that I actually have Windows. It's from the Fabricam domain. I can see the IP address, where down here a little bit further is an asset that I have discovered. You can see that thumbnail pop-up there has got more asset information than maybe one of these up here. Let's go into these assets and discover the differences between them. I'm gonna open up one of these here. Here's the asset that has got no credential applied to it. It's being discovered through our CDR, credential-free device recognition technology. And you can see there's a lot of empty fields on here, but there is some helpful and useful information. For example, the MAC address, the IP address. We do have some information that is on this page. If we go into the configuration, we can see this configuration page could contain a lot of information, but without the appropriate credentials, we may not be able to discover what all is needed. Same thing in the hardware page, information is missing. Software has not been discovered on this asset. Some features that may be installed in this asset are also not available. But let's see what this looks like and what these tabs all look like on an asset that has been discovered correctly. Here's an asset now that has been discovered and has had a credential assigned to it and has been discovered in the environment. You can see this page has got a lot more helpful information. The make, the model, the asset, the operating system of this particular machine, that with the build and the version. It even has some hardware information here with this optical, the hard drive, the graphics, memory, and CPU. We can go into the configuration tab here, and in this page, we have more information that's available. If my account here had permissions, we could actually see the appropriate recovery key for the BitLocker being listed there as well. Drivers are also listed for the different types of drivers and devices that are associated to your machine, and the list can go on and on. If we go into the software page, you can see the software that has been installed on this machine. Maybe your server has unique installs or configurations that'll be discovered under your features. If your server has SQL information can be discovered here as well. All this information is now discoverable when you assign a scanning credential to your device. So now that you've seen the power behind the credential-free device recognition versus the credentials, I hope that you can see the power behind and the magic behind Lansweeper when you actually get those credentials in there and you can start pulling out all that valuable information. We can start working with dashboards and reports and diagrams. And speaking of, let's dive into the features of Lansweeper and see what those things look like with all of this information been gathered from your environment. All right, here I have logged into the dashboard, and this is where I get real excited to see the power of Lansweeper at work. You're probably going to spend most of your time inside of the reports, so let's head straight there. There is a lot of reports. There are a lot of reports available for you. Out of the box, by default, there's 300 plus, and there's a good chance by the time you see this video, there's gonna be even more. We're continually adding reports here, and you can create your own as well. This is a very big topic, but let's take a look and just see what a report might look like. I like to look at security reports, so let's go into some security vulnerabilities. And I'm just gonna scroll down the page here. I know I've got one. Here's an open SSL vulnerability report. If I click into this report, I can see these assets that specifically have this vulnerability. And you can even put your mouse over, you can see the detail, you can click straight into one, you can get right into that particular asset and see the information about it. And as you can see, this is another area to see the risk insights. By clicking this, you'll see the particular risks that are associated or the vulnerabilities associated with this particular asset. So it's not just a report where you can gather this information, but you can see it within the individual asset as well. And as you can see with each of these vulnerabilities, speaking of vulnerabilities, let's go into the details of these. We can see at the high level here inside of an asset, the severity, how confident this particular vulnerability is, the description, when it changed, and so forth. But what if you wanted to see the vulnerabilities for the entire environment? For that, we can actually come over here to the Risk Insights section of Lansweeper and look at the active vulnerabilities. Oh my goodness, my lab has got many vulnerable problems here. But I think this is a very common thing in many networks. There's just a lot of vulnerabilities that often we are very unaware of, and that's where Lansweeper Power can come in as well. So we see all of these different assets with these different risk scores associated. This helps you to see those assets based off of risk score that are the most critical for you to solve. How many assets are associated, what the attack vector is, and the complexity. We can go into one of these CVEs. Let's just choose one here. And this particular one is specifically for the the Mozilla Corporation. And Lansweeper has gone out and discovered through our several different APIs connections, all of this information that helps you to discover what is going on with this particular vulnerability. We've got the references, different links you can click on. If there's any weakness enumeration here, there'll be these down here. There's just so much information for you to research and discover, but ultimately, I hope what you get out of this is recognizing that you have an asset that has a vulnerability and that it's something that you need to put your eyes on and take a look at. Another area that is very powerful that has been recently released is our diagrams. On this diagrams page, you can see a list of the different diagrams we have available, and they've split them into network topology diagrams and virtual environment diagrams. And the two have a lot of very powerful information. So to start with, let's look at the network topology. And I'm gonna go into this particular deployment, and we have a diagram here that is showing us all the different connections that are connected. So for example, I have a router here. Let me zoom in. And you can see this particular router has these connections to these particular assets. What's really neat too is this router is connected to this workstation, and this workstation has a specific monitor that we can track also connected to it. And each of these, we can put your mouse over, we can see these different connections. For example, we can select here and we can see the port that's on that router, the speeds, the type of the connection that's being made. Lots of information is gonna be available here. And you can observe and see your network environment in this format. You can also see it in the star format to give you a good visual of what your network might look like. Let me close this out, and we can also do the same thing within the virtual environment. We've got lots of other reports and things and diagrams that can be put out here for you, but there's a lot of information for you to be able to deep dive and learn about your environment in different ways. Something else I want to show you is our custom views. And this is really important to help you understand that this view of your assets is not the only view that you get to see. You can create a custom view that is going to design and lay out this particular page the way you want to design it. So I'm going to click on the custom view, and you can turn off certain things. Maybe you don't want to see details about the scanning issues and if you have duplicates in your environment. Maybe you don't need to know that it's the type of asset because you know all those things, or that the model and manufacturing model are not important to you. But maybe you want to know that you have the ADOU that's associated to these particular assets. We can come down and add all kinds of columns that you would like into your environment. And then you can arrange each of these also into the format that you would like by simply just moving these around. And once you have decided the layout that you like, hit apply. And now that we have the custom view, you might want to actually filter out certain assets or asset types. In this situation, let's go and do a filter here. And I want to actually filter out which ones have antivirus that's been enabled. So antivirus exists, hit apply, and there it is, my list of assets that have antivirus on the machine. You can also select, of course, many other options and features that are available. This list can be very extensive as to all the different opportunities and capability to filter to what your specific needs are. So with all this information that Lansweeper can provide, the next thing I want to talk to you about is integrations. Lansweeper does not want to keep all of the information to itself. In fact, we have built in many integrations into our platform in order to connect and sync with many of your applications out there as well. This is the power behind Lansweeper. We want to really help you by enriching so many other platforms that you use every day. Let's take a look at what some of these integrations look like and what integrations are currently built into Lansweeper. So here we are still on our custom view page. I'm going to come over to our marketplace, and right out the default, we can see all these different integrations that we have. So let's break this down a little bit into some of these topics. We've got the monitoring, the CMDB, service desk, and many of these other tabs that you see on top. It is really simple to make these integrations. We've worked with many of these other companies in partnering to make sure that these integrations go smoothly for you, that the discovered information that is found within your network through Lansweeper can come into PRTG as an example and enrich that environment there. Another area are CMDBs. We've had so many customers asking about having having Lansweeper bring into the other platforms for their CMDB awareness. And this is where the power of Lansweeper comes. We have so many other integrations. We also have an open API in the back end as well, where you can create your own connections to enrich other areas that maybe aren't currently built into Lansweeper. So I think that concludes our video here today on all this information at a really high level. Again, the purpose here is not to go in a deep dive, but to give you a quick understanding. If you can start to put information together into Lansweeper, the power that's really there. If you need more help on researching and discovering more about Lansweeper and how to create some of these integrations or how to help you with your scanning, I invite you to join us at community.lansweeper.com, where we have our knowledge center for the KBs and forums announcements. I also want to encourage you to watch our pro tips and our quick tech solutions that are there as well. Some of those may help you with the deployments. I look forward to working with you in the future, and as you continue to discover your network and add more scanning targets to your environment, I hope you continue to discover things in your network that maybe you never knew existed. Happy sweeping.